Morning, everyone, and I hope you are enjoying this lovely weather we're having, and hopefully it's going to be with us for a little while yet. I'm certainly pleased about it and doing lots of work in the garden and allotment. Today's service is about grace, and it is an elusive concept, and hopefully if I don't answer the question of what is grace, at least I'll get you all thinking. And we have a lovely story that is going to be read by Anne, our president. So we will begin our service as usual with the lighting of the candle. We light this candle as a symbol of our faith. By its light, may our vision be illumined. By its warmth, may our fellowship be encouraged. And by its flame, may our yearnings for peace, justice, and the life of the Spirit be enkindled. I invite you now to offer any lit candles for of joy and concern, of prayers that are in your thoughts.
I'm going to light a candle for joy and concern. Today is the ushering in of a new coalition government in Israel, and I hope with it is a renewed peace for the two-state solution. So we can but hope that that ushers in a new sense of urgency for peace, especially after such a horrific violence over the last couple of weeks.
Thank you, Robert. Yes, it would be an amazing miracle if a better peace was enkindled there. May all of our prayers be listened to. We now sing together, Spirit of Life.
Spirit of life, come unto me. Sing in my heart all the stirrings of compassion. Blow in the wind, rise in the sea. Move in the hand, giving life the shape of justice. Roots hold me close, wings set me free. Spirit of life, come to me, come to me.
We now have our opening prayer. We gather together, united by friendship, the Spirit and through grace. We pray that this time together may be a time of refreshment, inspiration, and a renewal of our desire to be instruments of grace. Let us be conduits of the divine by providing those we meet with unconditional love and guide our interactions with the environment to be healing ones, understanding the need to preserve creation for future generations. Let us be surprised and amazed by grace that lightens our darkness and guides us towards right action, knowing that grace is most evident in the margins. Amen. And we'll now have our first hymn, which I'm sure will be fabulous. And it certainly, I can't pass judgment on anyone because of my singing is so awful. So we're thankful for you, Robert.
As we have wept, and something to have done as we have done. It is something to have watched when all have slept, and seen the stars which never see the sun. Something to have smelt the mystic rose, although it breaks and leave the thorny rods. It is something to have hungered once as those must hunger who have ate the bread of gods. To have known the things that from the weak are fled, the fearful ancient passion strange and high, it is something to be wiser than the world, and something to be older than the sky. Lo, and blessed are eyes, for they have heard, yet blessed are eyes, for they have seen. Let the thunder break on people, beast and bird, and lighting it is something to have been.
We'll now have our story, which is a little bit longer than usual, but please bear with us. It's a beautiful story written about the last year. And if you get a chance to order it on Google, it is a beautiful, beautiful book. The illustrations are really wonderful, and to share it with friends and grandchildren alike. Thank you, Anne.
The story is called Together, words by Marianne Laidlaw and illustrations by Luke Adam Hawker. Life can seem like a machine in constant motion. There's no time to stop. The clock is ticking and there's somewhere we need to be. Even when we're too busy to think, our daily rhythm sweeps us along. We can rush through our days without seeing them. But I remember the storms that year. An uneasy feeling was creeping amongst us. Crowds began to dwindle. Dark clouds were looming in the distance. We watched them gather and we wondered, when will it come? How long will it last? It's hard not having all the answers. And at once, everything stopped. Life's engine ground to a halt. We could feel the weight of the dark sky overhead. Streets were suddenly deserted, quiet, where once there was an orchestra of noise. The busiest of places stood empty and still. Normal things began to feel strange. strange things began to feel normal. We were adrift. Fear can be a funny thing. It doesn't always shine a flattering light. It can make us forget that others are scared too. We took shelter, knowing the worst was yet to come. Weeks went by. It rained and rained. It felt like it would never end. Heroes amongst us stepped forward. They held us together and put others first. They were battling the storm in ways we could not even imagine. We were humbled by their courage. They deserved our applause and so much more. It's hard to be separated. Worries can seem to overflow. We felt so far apart. We began to understand the distances that had been already between us, and that loneliness can beat its drum loudest in a crowd. But being alone doesn't have to feel lonely. When life became smaller, we found space to see the bigger picture. Perhaps we were more similar than we had thought. We were united by our separation. We were together in being apart. We talked, we listened, we shared our sadness, grief, and worry. We shared our stories and experiences. Hard times can help us find the best we can be. Little things mean a lot. Some of us found we had more time. Time presents us with ideas to plant like seeds, and the patience to nurture them and watch them grow. We found new ways to keep in touch. Our homes became dance halls, bakeries. In slowing down, we woke up to the most important things of all. We began to understand that the sun was still there, rising, setting, waiting, even when the clouds were at their darkest. We marveled at nature and drew comfort from trees that had weathered storms for decades and still stood strong. Their endurance reassured us. We thought about their roots, strong and silent in the earth, and felt grounded. In a time of uncertainty, we found comfort in the seasons. The moon, the stars, and the birds in the trees watched over us. In stepping back, we had left the path clear for nature to step forwards. And when, slowly, the rain and winds began to subside, when the clouds became lighter and at long last sunlight filtered through, a new calm emerged. We valued our connections. We shared a kinder perspective. And now we look with hope to the future. Though the clouds may gather again and we may see other storms, we have realized most of all that we're stronger facing them together.
Thank you, Anne, for that beautiful reading of Together. With grace, we are together. We now say together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We now have our next hymn, The Love of God is Broader, and hopefully more familiar to you.
Thank you. there's a wideness in God's mercy, like the wideness of the sea. There's a kindness in God's justice, which is more than liberty. If we render love too narrow, with false limits of our own, then we magnify the strictness with a zeal God will not own. For the love of God is broader than the measures of the mind, and the heart of the Eternal is most wonderfully kind.
We now have a time of prayer and reflection. And I think after the last few months, you've figured out that I'm a 70s kid. And we'll have first a song from Neil Diamond, and then some silence, and followed by a musical interlude by Barry. And Neil Diamond will sing Pretty Amazing Grace.
Thank you so much. This one's called Pretty Amazing Grace.
Pretty amazing grace is what you showed me. Pretty amazing grace is who you are. I was an empty vessel. You filled me up inside. And with amazing grace, restored my pride. Pretty amazing grace is how you saved me. And with amazing grace, reclaimed my heart. Love in the midst of chaos, calm in the heat of war. Show with amazing grace what love was for. Forgave my insensitivity and my intent to then mislead you. You stood beside a wretch like me. Show your amazing grace. When grace was what I needed, stumbled inside the doorway of your chapel. Humbled and awed by everything I found. Beauty and love surround me, freed me from what I fear. Ask for amazing grace and you appear.
Pretty amazing. Pretty amazing.
Thank you, Barry. That was lovely. I enjoyed the tinkly bells. Those were really nice. Saying grace is to be thankful for food and those who prepared it. Grace under pressure is to be honorable. We would all like to age gracefully, or at least with a bit of flair. However, there but by the grace of God we go. For John Newton, that sweet sound of grace makes the blind see and finds the lost. Yet rapper Stormzy finds himself blinded by grace. I fall from grace, but I get up again. Grace is God incarnate. It is the Spirit moving us towards the good we seek, and the man we could do worse to emulate, Jesus. Grace is the joy after the sorrow, wisdom emerging from hardship, the positive motion overriding stagnation, and the miraculous just when it is needed most. Grace is that which is beyond what is necessary or expected. Grace is the effort, beauty, or kindness that fills the gap between utility and the extraordinary. Grace is easy to describe, but it remains elusive. St. Augustine wrote, "For grace is given not because we have done good works, but in order that we may do them." However, need to be in what modern parlance calls in a good place in order to reach out to others and work towards making a positive difference in the world. If we are caught up in our own challenges or in a state of depression, it makes it difficult to think outside those margins, beyond ourselves. Grace can be life-giving and repair what is broken, enabling us to contribute to the world in positive ways and to be better able to love unconditionally. Jane Goodall became famous for her work in Tanzania with chimpanzees. Since 1960, her study of these animals has changed the way we look at them. She's established the global conservation organization, the Jane Goodall Institute, and founded Roots and Shoots, which empowers young people to get involved in projects to benefit their communities, animals, and the environment. She delivered a lecture in 2016 called "Caring for the Earth: Reasons for Hope." In the talk, she answers the question, "I'm one person, what can I do?" Every single one of us makes an impact on this planet every single day. We cannot live through a day without making some kind of impact. And we have a choice. And if we start thinking about the consequences of the choices we make each day, the little things, what we buy, what we eat, what we wear, where did they come from? How was it made? Did it result in cruelty to animals? Was it child slave labor in a faraway place? Did it harm the environment? That kind of thing. But then we start making wiser choices. We can ask ourselves, do we have to buy this thing? If you think about everything, it's daunting. And I'm one person, what can I do? There's no point doing anything because I'm helpless and hopeless. And so people do nothing. And they shut it all away, and they don't even think about it. They don't want to think about it, because that would be depressing. So it's this apathy that needs to be overcome. And I found particularly with young people that when they start realizing that, yes, me alone, I can't do anything, but then when there's hundreds or thousands or millions, or maybe even eventually billions of people all making the right choices, all trying to leave a slightly lighter ecological footprint, then we can begin moving to the kind of world that we can be happier to leave to our descendants. Grace is being conscious of giving and receiving love. It is acting in such a way that exemplifies a life lived within the spirit and brings creation and everything in it closer to God. Conversely, when we are in that dark place or seemingly incapable of being surprised, we find ourselves experiencing grace when something affects us that causes us to meet God in a new way, spurring us to carry on in a more positive way. Grace is pure gift. Grace is something you can never get, but only be given. There's no way to earn it, or deserve it, or bring it about any more than you can deserve the taste of strawberries and cream. You can be the conduit for grace someone else experiences, but grace itself is more immense than any one individual. The Christian belief that grace is synonymous with redemption and the forgiveness of sin through the sacrifice of Jesus Christ need not be dismissed or dismantled. Grace surprises precisely because it is unconditional. It is the healing spirit that cures the ache in our souls. It unites our broken selves with the whole of the Holy Spirit. The truth is, we all commit errors, cause hurt, and are sinful within our human condition. Grace, whether it is felt through inward contemplation or outward gestures by strangers or those we have wronged, is outside our influence. We can't manipulate grace or contrive its existence. Grace provides the substance for belief in a power beyond ourselves. It is the foundation for our belief. Grace is the active ingredient in the great spirit that unites us all. Grace is the ripple of delight in our actions and the healing balm for our souls. Grace is the abiding force that feeds us and urges us to love unconditionally. Was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear, the hour I first believed. Amen. And we'll now have our final hymn, Abide With Me, and I hope you all sing it heartily in your living rooms.
Abide with me, fast falls the eventide, the darkness deepens, Lord, with me abide. When other helpers fail and comforts flee, help of the helpless, O abide with me. Swift to its close ebbs out life's little day. Earth's joy grow dim, its glories pass away. Change and decay in all around I see. O thou who changest not, abide with me. I need thy presence every passing hour. What but thy grace can foil the tempter's power? Who like myself, my guide and thy stay be? Thou cloud and sunshine, Lord, abide with me. I fear no foe, with thee at hand to bless. Ills have no weight, and tears no bitterness. Where is death's sting? Where grave thy victory? I triumph still if thou abide with me. Come then in light before my closing eyes. Shine through the gloom and point me to the skies. Heaven's morning breaks and earth's then shadow flees. In life, in death, O Lord, abide with me.
We now have our blessing. Through God's grace, we have prayed, sung from our hearts, and pondered deeply. May we move forward in blessing to share in the love, the joy, and peace of life. Help us to be the grace that others need. And when we in turn find it hard to be a presence of love, help us to be receptive to your grace. Amen. We now extinguish our candles. Though we extinguish the light of this candle, our faith burns on, our vision remains bright, our fellowship warm, and our yearnings for peace, justice, and the life of the Spirit constant. So be it until we meet again.
Go now in peace, go now in peace. May the love of God surround you everywhere, everywhere you may go. Go now in peace, go now in peace. May the love of God surround you everywhere, everywhere.
Thank you, everyone, Robert and Barry especially. We'll have hopefully a time to chat and see what you all thought about Grace. Grace Under Pressure, that was one I forgot. So we'll have a coffee and a chat.